Welcome to Hot Copy. The Miss Universe organization recently sparked controversy after it announced the decision that starting next year, transgenders and the so-called transsexual woman can already join the prestigious pageant traditionally reserved for women. And when we mean women, we mean biologically women. Here's a look at the ongoing debate and the changing landscape of beauty pageants.
On Sunday, Janine Tugunon was crowned Binibining Pilipinas Universe 2012 at the Araneta Coliseum. She won the title a year after she won first runner-up in 2012. Her court includes Binibining Pilipinas International Nicole Schmitz and Binibining Pilipinas Tourism Katrina Jane Dimaranan. Elaine Kay and Annalie Forbes won first and second runner-up. While beauty pageants and beauty have long been about women and their talents and beauty, recent developments in the international scene may soon test the tradition of beauty pageants the way we know them. Beginning next year, the Miss Universe organization says it will open all its pageants to transgender candidates. The decision came after Jenna Talakova, a transgender from Canada, was disqualified from the Miss Canada Universe competition after officials learned she was not born a woman. Conservatives objected to the plan.
I am a woman.
For transgenders across the globe, however, Talakova's victory is a victory for all of them. The president of the Society of Transsexual Women of the Philippines, Sir Strap Naomi Fontano, says it is an opportunity to make their situation known and for them to be accepted by society.
Malaman nila kung ano talagang ibig sabihin ng pagiging transgender, ay mabubuksan yung isip nila at unti-unti ay magbabago yung kanilang pananaw tungkol sa mga transgender at matatanggap nila na kami ay mga babae talaga.
But the Miss Philippines Earth and Miss Earth Beauty pageant officials are opposed to allowing the inclusion of transgender candidates.
I don't think we're ready for that yet, especially the Philippines.
The Binibining Pilipinas Charities, meantime, says it will hold off judgment until it gets guidelines from the franchise.
And joining us on Hot Copy is Pat Bringas, actually one of the members of the UP Student Council and current president of the UP Babaylan. She recently won as a council member for UP. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And I'd have to say, if I wasn't told or didn't know or I saw you, I would just think that you are a regular girl. No, really.
Thank you, Ma'am Karen.
No, I swear, I was so surprised.
But I am a woman.
Okay, first, give us the definition. What is the difference between a transgender and a transsexual?
Well, basically, transgender is an umbrella term for those who look and feel different from the sex they are assigned at birth.
Okay.
And on the other hand, transsexuals are those who have the desire to alter their bodies to reflect what they feel inside or how they identify themselves. Like, let's say if you are born a male and you identify yourself as a woman, then you will make efforts to look like a woman.
So you are a transsexual?
Yes.
Okay. Because the reason you look like a woman, and I presume you've taken hormones.
Yes. Yeah.
All right. Now tell me about it. When did you first discover that you were gay?
Actually, very, very early in my life, like 4 or 5 years old, I felt different already. Like,
yeah.
I wasn't one of the boys. Like, I tried to be one of them, but no, I preferred staying at home, singing to Whitney Houston.
Okay.
And not playing basketball.
That's a sign that you're not a guy. And then,
when I entered school, I saw, syempre, pagka pumasok tayo sa school, nakita natin yung mga iba't ibang klaseng tao.
Yeah.
And then, I identified more with those who were like me, na parang feminine talaga sa pagkilos. Yun.
Okay, but I presume you were gay at first.
I thought I was gay at first. Kasi that's what I was exposed to. I didn't know about transgenders yet.
Okay, all right. And what is the difference for you then?
For me, it was just like looking feminine, not actually living full-time as a woman.
Okay.
And then when I entered college and joined UP Babaylan, the LGBT org in UP, I was open to the world of transgenderism, and yun nga na parang I understood that transgenders identify as a woman, and that's how I felt all along.
Yeah.
So that's when I started transitioning into from the regular bakla into this.
So you're 20 years old now, am
yes,
I correct?
Yes.
Tell me, what have you done?
So far, I just took hormones.
Okay.
Pero I plan to undergo surgery to look more womanly.
Now when you take hormones, I did a documentary on this before for Correspondence. Mm-hmm. How long does that take, and what physical changes happen when a man takes? I presume, were you taking estrogen and progesterone?
Yes. Actually, I'm taking regular contraceptive pills for women.
Okay. All right. Okay, go on.
Basically, the effects are, it softens your features, like it adds fat to your body, and it makes your skin clearer and finer.
Yes, yes, that's true. Because men only have testosterone.
Yeah.
Women have testosterone, estrogen, and progesterone all together.
Yes.
Okay, so your Adam's apple went away?
Not really, it's still there.
But I can't see it.
It will go out.
How long have you been taking hormones?
Just a year.
Just a year. Now, how did your parents take this?
Of course, they were concerned for my health.
For your health.
Because there's not much research about taking hormones for men.
Yeah.
I mean, female hormones for men, right?
Yes.
So they were concerned for my health, but I guess they kind of accepted it eventually, because they saw that I was happy.
I
became
nice.
More comfortable with myself.
So first, when you transitioned to first revealing you were gay, you did not have a difficult time with your parents?
Well, I think it's hard for parents to accept that their child is different from what they expected them to be.
Yeah.
So I kind of understood that, and it was a gradual process of acceptance for them.
Okay. Now, when you started becoming female, did you feel any, in other words, discrimination? Was it difficult for some of your classmates or people you knew just to say, what are you doing?
Actually, with my friends, I think they kind of expected me to go this way. Like, they knew that I was very, very feminine when I was young, and they just expected me to transition into this. But maybe the others who did not know me well, yun yung naka-experience ako ng discrimination na lalaki ka, bakit ka nagdadamit babae? Bakit ka umaaktong babae?
Okay, and then what would you say?
This is me. This is how I am. So I just hope that you accept it.
Yeah. Actually, it takes a lot of courage to actually become you. You know what I mean?
Yeah, to actually change your whole appearance to match how you feel inside. It's
or to find, actually, in a bigger spectrum, just to go where you are happy. Mm-hmm. Because we are expected to live a certain way, you know what I mean?
Yeah, how society expects
exactly,
you to be.
Or how your parents expect you, or how you believe life should be. To go your way is actually a form of courage, I think.
Yeah, of course, because you're going against the norm, and it's very difficult in our society to do so.
Yeah. Now, you have not undergone surgery.
Not yet.
Okay. You think you are prepared for that?
Emotionally, not yet, because I've lived in this body for so long, and I've kind of accepted it already.
Yes.
But maybe there are little things that I want to change in my body.
Like, I'm just curious.
One thing is my breast.
Okay. But there are women that are flat chested.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, you know, I'm curious.
But yeah, to look more feminine.
Like, okay.
Just my breast, actually. That's what I thought of. Because other surgeries, I haven't really thought about.
Yeah, now I've seen myself personally, a sex change. When I went to Thailand.
Wow.
Yes, yes, I met someone on the hospital bed. And it takes so much psychological change in your mind to actually change yourself.
Yes,
you know what I mean?
Yes, yes. And that's what, that's part of the reason why I haven't really thought about undergoing sexual reassignment surgery, because it's a permanent surgery that
Correct.
Will change you forever.
And, yeah.
And I have friends who have undergone SRS, and just taking off part of you is kind of difficult to accept.
Yeah. Para ka rin pinuputulan ng kamay dun eh.
Yeah. Diba? It's part of you. That's part mawawala siya.
Oh, but do you feel less of a woman?
Now? Before surgery? No, because being a woman should not be defined with the organ between your legs. I mean, it should be, it's in between your ears. It's in your mind and in your heart. Womanhood is in your mind and your heart.
I'm so amazed with that statement. Being a woman should not be defined
by the
by
organ.
What? By the organ that's between your legs. So that's amazing. So you believe that it's but right that they accept transgenders and transsexuals to Miss Universe?
Oh, definitely. Because what is a woman? Who defines a woman? Who determines whether you are a woman or not? It's about you. It's not them. Like, it should not be based on, like I said, what's your organ between your legs, but how you feel. If you identify yourself as a woman, then you are a woman.
Now, in Miss Universe, do you agree that transgender sexuals who have had sex change should be allowed? I mean, someone like you has not yet had a sex change. Mm-hmm. Should you be allowed to join Miss Universe?
I think yes. As long as you identify yourself as a woman, then beauty pageants like Miss Universe are for women. And so we should be allowed to.
But isn't that strange? It's like a woman who identifies herself as a man being mm-hmm. allowed to join Mr. Universe. Mm-hmm. I mean, if you take it in the reverse, it's also slightly weird.
It might be weird, but we should be allowed to do whatever we want, like what we feel. And if a transgender female to male transgender wants to join Mr. World
Universe, let's say,
they should be allowed to, as long as they feel that they are eligible for that contest, then why not?
Shouldn't you have your own contest, like Miss Transgender World or something?
There are contests for transgenders, but I think the fact that there's a presence of these contests, I think it's a sign that there's inequality between womanhood, because the fact that there are transgender pageants, it gives an opportunity for transgenders to compete, because as women, we should be allowed to dream and become beauty queens. And those transgender pageants are just a venue for us to live that dream. But the ultimate goal, I think, is to be accepted as women, as
Yeah. So I'm curious, what does it say in your passport?
Male.
So ano yun? Yeah, I mean, in your mind and in your heart, you're a woman.
Yes.
But in all the documents, you're still male.
Yes.
Yeah. Do you enter a woman's bathroom or a men's bathroom?
Yeah, I use a woman's bathroom because that's where I feel comfortable. It would be uncomfortable for me to use the men's bathroom.
And frankly, the men might freak out when you enter their bathroom because you look like a woman.
Actually, before I've tried, they were like, why are you here?
Diba?
So para ano, less gulo na lang, sige, sa woman na.
And no one minds you there?
Yeah.
No one minds you?
No one. It's okay.
No, I don't think anybody would. Now, your documents, tell us about that. Do you want it changed?
Yes, of course, because it's quite difficult for me, especially when I travel. Like,
Correct. Like
you mentioned, the passport. Pagka ano sa immigration office, actually,
hindi ka ba kini-question
all the time?
Oh my God,
is this you?
Like kunyari Hong Kong, ganon. You're traveling.
Actually, in Australia.
Oh, Australia.
They even called someone else to verify that I was the one in that passport. Parang tinignan talaga nila yung face ko, yung features ko na sige, nag-match dito sa picture on the passport. But it says male.
Does your passport picture have you looking like this? And when you were a boy?
Mga 4 years ago kasi.
Oh my gosh.
I was a guy.
Yes.
Yeah, and it's difficult na parang that's my ID. Tapos parang kina-question nila kung ako talaga yun. So masakit siya. In some way. And
anong pinakamasakit na alam mo yun na naranasan mo?
Actually, yun.
Yun na, no? Yung parang... Tsaka sa immigration, nakakaya kasi yun
exactly.
Alam mo yun, ang tagal, kini-question ka.
Hold back ka, na parang ikaw ba talaga to? It's like, parang hindi ikaw to eh, na yeah. This is not yours.
Yeah,
parang,
no, I have a running joke, ha? You know, mm-hmm. Abner Mercado, who's a friend of mine, mm-hmm. who's a correspondent here.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, there was one time I felt he was stereotyped that he looked like a terrorist.
Oh,
when
wow.
we were traveling.
Wow.
So like they strip, you know what I mean? Yeah. How they do it in immigration, that
yes.
it's really long, they mm-hmm. they single you out.
Exactly. Parang, butin lang may Adam's apple ako.
That's
what I show them, na parang, oh, I'm a male, that's actually mean.
Oh my gosh. You know, you look like Rian Ramos.
Ay, talaga?
Someone said that?
Yeah, so my friends.
See?
Pero hindi ako
nangyumalasing
din agad ni Mr. Rian Ramos.
No, you look like her. You look alike. Okay,
you.
We'll take a quick break. When we return, our guest Pat Bringas of UP Babaylan will answer questions from you, our viewers. Hot Copy, we'll be right back.